Hi, Phyllida. I'm Sarah from the Upcoming.
Hello.
Thank you so much for taking the time to speak with us.
Nice to meet you.
Maybe just to kick off, you could give us a brief intro to this wonderful film, Herself.
It's a film about a woman in the aftermath of leaving an abusive relationship. It's a film that looks at such a character, not as a victim, but as somehow an agent of her own rebuilding, and is a story of how she comes together with a community to actually build a house, but to rebuild her life.
And it's quite a contrast to your other forays into cinema, you know, Mamma Mia and Iron Lady. I understand actually the roots of it began when you were doing your all-female Shakespeare, which, by the way, is one of my favourite stage productions of all time. It's absolutely wonderful. I understand that's when you first started working with Clare and some of the ideas for this film came about.
Yeah, I mean, Clare and Harriet, who plays Peggy in the movie, we were all working together on the all-female Shakespeare's and they were the productions were set in a women's prison, and we were doing a lot of work with women prisoners and very preoccupied by how many women had starts of in domestic violence as children and ended up in going into the criminal justice system, and just how rife this was. And at that time, a friend of Claire's became homeless with three kids, and she was incidentally struggling to get work on screen, but that wasn't really why she started to write this. She wanted to just sit down and write her friend into a kind of different future. And she was just so outraged by the lack of social housing. And she asked me to read it at first, just like, have a read of this and what do you think and give me some feedback. And I was trying to do another movie at the time. And then as time went on, I got more and more involved. And then one day somebody said, God, Claire's really written. Because she wasn't going to be in the film at first. She was going to play like a little sister character that she'd written, thinking, actually, it's too much to hope that I'm going to write this and star in it. Let's just get the film made and I'll play a small role. And when I heard someone say, God, she's written this central character though for like a great, great movie actress, I was like, yeah, herself, not a great movie actress. She is that actress. And that's when I thought, I sod this, I'm going to direct this film and I'm going to make sure Claire gets to play the lead and the world gets to see her in action.
And, you know, you do always put women and women's experiences center stage in your work. And what I love about this is it's not just kind of the archetypal battered woman. So there's a lot of authenticity there. Was that something that was very important to you?
Yeah, I mean, it being slightly mold-breaking in terms of the character, I think that Claire spoke to a lot of agencies. We did a lot of research for the film and she spoke to a lot of agencies in Ireland. And a woman from Women's Aid there, who was working in a Women's Aid charity shop, Claire was telling her about this. And she said, if you write this story, don't make this character a victim, because these women are not victims. They're actually quite heroic and they have so much courage to stay in these situations and even more to go. So it was very much, we were determined to kind of, I don't know, just not make her perhaps what you expect her to be, but that she would be this agent of her own kind of her own destiny on some level.
And, you know, thinking about where we are right now in terms of the pandemic, we've seen a lot of these situations, domestic abuse, people going to food banks worsening. But then we've also, there's things that come out in the film about the kindness of strangers and community also being exaggerated. So is that something that would make it hit home even more right now?
Yeah, I think so. I think, you know, when we made the film, we thought it was about isolation and community. And then suddenly the pandemic unfolded and we were like, oh my God, here are, you know, we're all thinking, am I a good neighbor? You know, can I help my neighbors? Would my neighbors help me in a situation? Or is that woman in that apartment okay on her own? What's going on in there? There seem to be, you know, and so all of the themes that are in the film seem very pertinent. And we, you know, like all movie directors, of course, I want my movie to be on the big screen. And, you know, we were all talking about, oh, we've got to watch this as a community because it's about community. But you're then going, hang on a minute, maybe this film, when it gets to streaming platforms, will be able to get into people's homes who are in this situation and offer some kind of message of consolation or inspiration. So we've had a very different sort of shift in our thinking about, yes, of course we want it to be in movie theaters and we're thrilled it's going to be, but we also know there's a time after that where maybe it comes as like a little paper dart of you know, hope.
I think I'm out of time, but thank you so much for sharing all that with me, and congratulations on this really wonderful film.
Lovely to meet you. Bye.
Great to meet you. Thanks a lot. Bye.